now that we have rescued a whole bunch of motors from the junk, it's time to test a few of these just to see what they're capable of. Welcome to another one of my videos. Now, for this exercise, we're going to need a board with a hole in it. It's going to take a piece of broomstick. Then, another piece of board, just a piece of scrap with another hole in it to then go over. So that's going to go right down the bottom. Actually, it's probably better on the bottom. And I'm going to turn it over and cut it off here. Then I can put it on the top again and then use this distance to cut my corners off to make my circle. And then move it around to the next piece and cut those pieces off. Then with it in a vise, using that top there as your guide, you're going to then cut off those little points. Now we're going to turn this into a pulley, so I'm going to get a piece of board about a couple of millimeters thick and just clamp it to the table. Put the wheel on that, and then the saw, I'm going to run it on top of the board and score a line right around here. Flip it over and do the other side. Then with it back in the vise again, I'm going to take my saw, put it in that groove and cut a 45 degree from both sides eventually to cut that V out of there. Then clean it up with some sandpaper. So there we have our pulley. Now the next thing is some bearings. We could get fancy and do them in metal and stuff, but for this exercise we'll just do them in wood, a couple of blocks, and bore some holes in more or less the same place. Then I'm going to put the two blocks onto a board, and I'm going to bore some holes through and then screw the bottoms on. Countersink it and then in with my screw. Now with a bit of oil or grease, Mum will just stick that in the hole there and lubricate it. Or some oil, maybe both, I don't know, some grease. Put it in there and that should get it spinning for us. Now a little piece of broomstick with a hole down the middle. And with a wood screw that'll go through with a piece that doesn't have the screw up the top so it doesn't grind out the thing. And screw it onto the wheel. You'll find the place you can put it out further, it'll go, you'll have to wind it faster if you go in there, it'll, you can try it in different positions anyway. Now in order for this to run true and also to take up any little wobble that I might have in that joint, I'm going to take that wheel off and then take a saw and cut a slice through there. Actually, it's probably more easier in the vise. Then from a stick, I'm going to cut a wedge. Then with it, the wheel back on there, and it running true, and put it into the groove there and tap it in with a hammer to expand it and tighten the joint. Then I'll cut it off with a blade. So now it's running fairly true. I've also put a spacer in there just to reduce the friction of it rubbing against this block here. Now we will need a belt. Now, I could use a couple of some thin string and tie a knot in it, but you'll find that that knot becomes a problem. It is okay. But let's do something better. We can take some thread here and go around the wheel in a block on the table to more or less where it's, the motors are going to go. And go around once, tie a knot just to fix it. Then we're going to go around maybe 10 or 15 times and winding it around it as well until we get sort of an endless rope with no knots in it, or the knot is very small. And once you get to that final knot again, just tie it off. Then I'm going to take some glue, some flexible glue, whether it be rubber glue or whatever, or even paint, something that's going to bind it in a flexible sort of way. And I might put several coats of this on just to make it bind and be a nice belt. So that now that belt will spin quite nicely on those little pulleys without a knot in the way.